Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see the pentest partition problem. So this is a hard problem, therefore I would request you to watch this video very carefully and completely. So let us look at the problem statement. In this problem it says that we have n pentings and k number of painters, and each painter has same speed. In 1 unit of time, a painter can paint 1 unit of a painting. So our goal is to divide the paintings among the painters so that the work is done in minimum possible time. A painter can only paint the adjacent paintings. So I have already taken an example where we have 4 paintings. So n equals to 4. And we have 3 painters, therefore k equals to 3. Now we want to divide this work in such a way that the total paintings are done in the minimum possible time. And there was also a constraint that a painter can only paint the adjacent paintings. So here I have divided this into 3 parts, and you can see that this is the most optimal division. Dividing this, it takes the first painter will paint these 2 paintings in 50 units of time. The second painter will paint in 60 units and the third painter will paint in 30 units. So the total work will be done in the maximum of these 3, that is 60 units of time, since these 3 workers are working parallelly. Now there is one more constraint, which is if there is one painting, then it cannot be shared among painters. If a painter picks a painting, then he will have to do it completely. Okay. Now this problem can be thought of in a different manner, that is, given an array of elements, we want to divide this array into k different partitions such that the sum of the maximum sum subarray is having the minimum value. So this is the intuition for solving this question. Now divide an array of size n into k subarrays such that the sum of the max valued subarray is minimized. So I have taken a different example having 5 paintings and we have 3 painters. Now we want to find a configuration such that we will assign some of these paintings to some of the workers in such a way that if they work parallelly, then the painting time is minimized. You can see that I have given a configuration which is taking the minimum possible painting time. In this case, the first painter will paint these first 2 paintings, second painter will paint this second painting, and third painter will paint these last 2 paintings. Now this can be thought of as an array of elements, and we want to divide this array into k different partitions in such a way that the sum of the maximum sum subarray is minimized. In this case, you can see that the maximum sum subarray is having value 60, and if you take any other subarray, then it will have a value greater than 60, like if you try some different configuration. So in this configuration, the painting time is 60 and this is minimum. You can try it with different configurations. So I hope you got the problem statement and the intuition for this question now. So let us look at how can we solve it. So let us take n equals to 6 paintings and k equals to 3 painters. Now with a very simple approach, we want to calculate the maximum subarray sum for all possible configurations. So we need to create all possible configurations. Now how can we do it? Let us take the configurations from the right hand side. Now the first painter can have any of these paintings, that is, we can partition at any point. So for each painter, there will be n possible partition points. So for k painters, the partition points will be n into, and this will be k times. So what will be the number of configurations which can be formed? This will be n to the power k. So this algorithm will actually take order of n to the power k time, which is exponential. So how do we solve it actually? Let us put the first partition here. We could have put it anywhere, but let's put it in the first place. Then this first painting will go to the first painter. Now for the second painter, it can choose any of these painting positions, and also it can overlap with this position. Now overlapping of the position means that the second painter will not take any of the paintings. So if we give the second partition here, then the gap is containing no paintings. So the second painter will not be getting any painting. So let us just exclude this case, and let's say the second painter is partitioned here. So the second painter has also got one painting, and the third painter will get the rest of the paintings. So how much time will it take? This is taking 100. So the third painter will complete in 100 time units, second painter will complete in 40 time units, and the first painter will complete in 50 time units. So what will be the painting time? It will be maximum of these 3 values, so this will come out to be 100. Now we want to find such a partition configuration so that this 100 is minimized. So if we just take out this value and we put it here, then you can see that this value will be 70, this will be 70 as well, and this will be 50. So here in this case, the time is minimized and this has become 70. So in this way, we will try all possible configurations. For each configuration, there will be one maximum value. And for say n possible configurations, we will have n maximum values. And from those maximum values, we will take the value having the minimum value as our optimal configuration, because we want to divide the work among k painters in such a way that it takes minimum time to paint all these paintings. So let us look at how can we solve this by using recursion and backtracking. So in this approach, we will actually iterate from the right hand side. You can also iterate from the left hand side, it's your wish. We will pick a partition point for the first painter, and we will assign all the elements from the partition point to the right hand side to the first painter, and then the rest of the subarray to k-1 painters. So let's say we partition at this point. So now this first painting has been assigned to painter 1, and the rest of the paintings has to be divided between the rest of the two painters since our k value is 3. Now let's say the second painter has got this second value. So now this is belonging to this second painter, and the rest of the paintings have to be divided between only one painter. So this goes to one painter. Now for all these values, we will calculate the maximum of the subarray sum. So in this case, we can see that we have already used here the max value. Max value of what? Max value of all the partitions, that is all the subarrays. So in this case, when k is 3, then we will have 3 subarrays. So we will take the maximum of all these 3 subarrays, and then we will compare it with our best value. Initially, the best value will be taken as int max. So this is basically taken in order to check with different types of configuration. So this is one configuration, and here you can see that the max value will come out to be 100. So this will be replaced by 100 value. Now we will try with a different configuration. Let's say this was not put here and the first painter got this partition at this location. Then this P1 will be having a value of 90 time. Now the second painter, let's say, gets this position, so it will be getting 30 value, and this third painter will be getting a value of 40 plus 20 plus 10, which is 70. So the max value comes out to be 90. Now 90 will be compared with the previous best value, which is 100. So you can see that this 90 is actually lower than the previous best 100. So you will get a new best, which is 90. So this new configuration is actually giving us an optimal value as compared to our previous configurations. So in this way, we will try for all possible configurations and find out the best value along with the best possible configuration. So this is how we can solve it by using backtracking. In recursion, we solve one step and assume that the other steps are already solved. So this is a very basic approach for the recursion. Now I have already written the pseudocode for this recursion approach, and we will actually be using a for loop, because for each possible painter, we can partition it at n different locations. Therefore, we will have to use a for loop. It will basically be a tree structure. So I hope you are able to imagine it, where you will have n different branches. And you can also see that after doing the partition, we are taking the sum of the right subarray, and then we are dividing the array into two parts, and we are actually calling this partition call with the left subarray. So here I have already passed the location as ik-1. This denotes that I is basically the array size, which is n, and k-1 is the number of painters. So I hope you are able to understand this backtracking approach. Now this will be taking exponential time, since we have already explained that there will be order of n to the power k different configurations possible. So let us see how can we write this approach in a simple manner. Let's say we have n number of paintings and we have k number of painters. Then we can divide this problem into two parts, where we will make a partition and we will find the sum of the right subarray. Okay, so this is basically the sum of the right subarray, and the left subarray will be passed to the partition call again with a decreased n value, because we will be taking this new partition point as our n value, and k will also be decreased by one value, since one painter is already assigned to the paintings which is on the right hand side of this partition. So this is basically saying this point. This is making the recursion call. Now for this configuration, we will be taking the maximum sum subarray value. Okay, so for this reason we have taken this max value, and we will be taking this for all possible configurations. We will be doing this for all possible configurations, and from all possible configurations we will be taking the minimum of the maximum sum subarray value. So this will give us the optimal configuration which we should follow in order to divide the n paintings into k different painters. So I hope you understood this formulation. Now there are two base cases. Basically, when you have just one painting, then no matter how many painters are there, your painting time will still be the same, that is array at 0, which is the single painting time, because we cannot share a single painting among different painters. So this was also a constraint. Now this second case says that if we have n different paintings and only one painter, then the total time taken will be the sum of all the painting times. So this is very logical here. Now the time taken by this formulation approach is basically exponential. So we want to improve this backtracking approach. We can basically try applying dynamic programming, but before applying, we should search for these two properties, which is the optimal substructure and overlapping subproblems. Then only the DP approach will be helpful. Now for this optimal substructure, it says that if we can solve a smaller subproblem, then solving many smaller subproblems will lead to solving our bigger problem. So this we can already see that in this formulation, we were actually dividing this entire array into different partitions, and we were calling partition on this smaller subarray and solving this smaller subarray, and using this already solved partition, which is the sum value, we can solve the entire array value. Okay, so this is basically like dividing a larger problem into smaller subproblems and then solving those smaller subproblems to get the solution for the larger problem. So this follows the optimal substructure approach. Now for this overlapping subproblems, let us take an example. Here I have taken 6 paintings and 5 painters. Now if we do 2 different configurations, then you can see that these 2 configurations are actually matching. So these 2 partitions are actually matching. So once you calculate for this partition and for this partition, then we don't need to again calculate for the same. And so you can see that we have repeating subproblems. So what can we do? We can actually save the already calculated values in a table so that we can use it again if it is required without even computing it again. So this will actually improve our time complexity. So why do we always make table in DP? DP is just a technique to learn previously found solutions and save it so that when it is required in future, then we can just look up the table for pre-computed solution and return the value. It saves a lot of time. So let us take the example and solve it by using DP approach. In this table, we will take a DP table of size n plus 1 and k plus 1, where n is the number of paintings and k is the number of painters. So here I have taken n equals to 6 and k equals to 3. So I am basically taking the same example. So we will just pre-fill the first 2 columns and the first 2 rows. So the first row here, the 0th row, indicates that when we have no painter, then no matter how many paintings are there, actually we will not be able to paint it. So we will fill it with all zeros. When we have only one painter, this first row, only one painter, then no matter how many paintings are there, the time taken will be the sum of all the painting times. So this is why we are just doing the sum of these values. Now for this first column, no matter how many painters are there, if we have no paintings, then it won't take any time. So it will be filled with all zeros. And for this first column, no matter how many painters are there, it will still take the time taken for this first painting, because a painting cannot be shared among painters. So this time will be copied in the first column. Now we need to calculate the values for this rest of the cells from k equals to 2 to k and n equals to 2 to n. So this last cell for DP at kn will give us our answer. And this will basically say that if we have n elements and k different painters, then this will be the optimal time which will be taken to paint all these paintings. So let us now solve this problem. You can see that I have taken a for loop for all the rows and a for loop for all the columns. That is, this will iterate through all the cells, and for each cell this will be the operations. So let us take the first cell, which is 2,2, and do an operation. So for 2,2, we can see that the best value which we have already assigned, which will be int max initially, because we want to find the minimum best value. Okay, so we will give it a maximum value initially. Now we will iterate for all possible partitions. So for all possible partitions, this will be the for loop, which will iterate from 1 to j, because j is denoting what will be the size of our array. Initially this n value is 2, because a 2,2 or n value is 2, so we are basically considering these 2 elements. So initially our array is containing only 2 elements, 10,40. Now we want to partition it into 2 parts. Now what will be the optimal partition? Actually we can partition it in between, or we can partition it at the side. So if you partition it in between, then the first one will take 10 units of time, second one will take 40 units of time. If we partition it at the end, then the first one will take 50 units and the second one will take 0, because the second one is not having any work to do. So these are the two possible partitions which are found with this for loop. So there are two possible partitions. The max value of the first configuration is 40 and the max value of the second configuration is 50. Now this is found by this max value. And then this min value is actually taking the minimum of these two maximum, which will be 40. So it is saying that the best configuration will be this one. By dividing this in middle, this will give us the best configuration, that is the best time. So after performing these operations, that is after checking for all possible configurations, we are just updating this DP value at ij with best. So best value here is 40, so it will be updated with 40. So I hope you are getting how are we doing this. Let us now look at the next cell, which is 2, 3. So how do we want to solve it? Actually at 2, 3, we are having 3 elements, that is these first 3 elements, 10, 40 and 20. So we have 10, 40 and 20. Now our k value is still 2 because we are in the second row. So k is 2. So we can make only a single divider, because that will divide it in two different parts, and so two different painters will be given the work. So we can divide it here. If we divide it here, then the values which will come out is, this will be 10 and this will come out to be 60. So what is the max value? Max value is 60. If we divide it in the second region like this and we remove this, then the first one will take a time of 50, second one will take a time of 20. If we again remove it and divide it here, then the first one will take the entire time, which is 70. Second one will take only 0 time. So the max of this second value was actually 50 and max of this third value is 70. Now we have checked for 3 different configurations which were possible with k equals to 2 and n equals to 3. Now we will take the minimum of these 3 values as our optimal configuration. So minimum is 50, so we will fill here 50. And our configuration is actually, we will make a division at this point after 2 elements. So I hope you are understanding it, how this DP table is filled. Now if you want to solve this 3, 3 using the DP table, then let's see how can we solve this. Actually, we are given these 3 values only, and our k value is 2 here because we are in row number 2. So we are iterating from p equals to 1 to j, and j's value is actually 3 here. So we can make 3 different possible partitions. Let's say we make a partition here. So we will be finding the sum of this right subarray, which will be 60. And then for this left subarray, we will look at the pre-computed value, which is dp at I minus 1 and p. That is, we want to calculate this value. And so we have made a partition at the first point. So we will find the sum of these two values. And then for this rest of the left subarray, we will go to that location I minus 1 and p. P's value is initially 1. So we will look at this value, which is 10. And so 10 will be taken here. Now, why are we moving to I minus 1 p? Because this current painter is taking the total time of this sum value, which is 40 plus 20. Now the rest of the paintings will be done by k minus 1 painters. Because since we have 2 painters and 1 painter is already painting in this sum value time, then the rest of the painters will be painting in some other time, and so 1 painter will be decreased. So if we decrease 1 painter, then it will be from k to k minus 1. So our k value is initially I. Okay, so I is equals to 2 here, and so we will move to one lower number of painters, and we will have to remove all these paintings which is being painted by the current painter. So it is painting these two paintings, so we will remove it. So for removing this, we are actually taking the P value, because at P we are making the partition. So we will go to this location 1, since this N equals to 2 and 3 are being painted by the current painter. So if we have just one painting and K equals to 1 painter, then the time taken is already stored in DP. So it will be 10. So here it is 10. Now the maximum time of these two values is 60. Now we will take a different configuration. So we will take this same array and we make a partition here, because our P's value will increase and P will now be equals to 2. So when P is equals to 2, then this will be the sum value for the current painter. So the current painter is painting this one painting only. So this is taking 20 time. Now the rest of the painters, which will be k minus 1, and our k value here is actually 2, so it will be 1 minus 1, which is 1. Now this one painter will have to paint all these paintings on the left subarray. So this is already computed in this DP table, so we will have to just look it. We will have to decrease one painter, that is I minus 1, and we will have to look at the partition position. So if we go to 1, that is I minus 1, this 1th row, and this P, that is a partition point, which is this 2. So our new partition point is at 2, this value is 50. So this first pointer will paint it in 50 times. Now what will be the max value of these two? Max will be 50. Okay. So the best was initially int max and we had found 60. So best was updated to 60 and now we have found 50. So best will again be updated to 50 value. Okay. Now there is one more partition which can be done. If we remove this and make a partition here, then basically this painter will not be painting anything and so it will take 0 time. And for the rest of the painters, which in this case is only one painter, will have to paint all these paintings. So this will again be computed by dp at I minus 1 and p. P, that is the partition point, is actually 3 here. So we will go to this column 3 and k value 1, that is row 1, it is taking 70. So this entire time will be 70. So in this case the max value will be max of 70, 0, which will be 70. Now the best value already stored is 50, so it will not get updated. So our best configuration time is 50, so this dp at ij will be replaced with 50 value. So I hope you understood how are we doing this using dp table. Now let us look at the time complexity for this approach. We have basically k into n number of cells. So the number of cells is k into n. And you can see that for each cell, we are actually making n number of partitions, because this value of j is maximum n. So we can have all the elements in an array and so we will make a partition at all the points. And this will be possible for this last column only. So in the worst case, we will have to include it. And so this p's max value is n. So we will make n partitions at max for each of these cells. So the total time complexity will be k n square. Okay. In this case, you can see that we were required to find the sum values because we had to find the sum values of a given range again and again. So in order to decrease the time complexity to just O1 for the range query, what we will do is we will make a cumulative sum array. And here we will take out all the cumulative sums of all the values. Now the range query can be done in just O1 time. So when you do this, then your time will be k n square. If you don't do this, then for each time you will have to traverse the array and make the sum. So it will be k n cube. So I think this optimization is very simple to do. So this was the painter's partition problem. I hope you were able to understand it. This was a difficult problem. So if you have any type of doubt, then feel free to comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Please rewind the video and watch some sections again if you have any type of doubt in those locations. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of this programming video. See you in our next video. Thank you.